Hello and welcome to another video. Today I'll show you an overview of the workflow for the Rush Hour vehicle importer. This workflow is optional. Rush Hour continues to support regular Chaos wheeled vehicles, and the vehicle importer produces regular Chaos wheeled vehicles as well. The aim of the importer is to massively improve the speed of getting a working vehicle into Unreal and bring powerful studio level tools to teams of all sizes. The importer will be expanded over time with new and more powerful features. We're going to begin with the documentation website. This will always have the latest documentation on features and troubleshooting information. I encourage you to check out this page thoroughly, and it will also always have the link to the latest Blender add-on. Let's start by scrolling to installing the Blender add-on and clicking the latest release link. This will take us to the GitHub page, and we just want to download this source code zip file here. Click that and wait for it to download. I've already downloaded the Blender add-on and it's right here. So once you've got that downloaded, let's open up Blender. So to install the add-on, we go up to Edit Preferences. We go to the Add-ons tab, click Install, navigate to where we downloaded the add-on file, click it and click Install Add-on, and then it should appear right here. And we just tick Yes on that, and we have the plugin enabled. If we press N on the keyboard, that's N for November, we can see this menu pops up and we can see the Rush Hour Unreal Vehicle tab here. So now we need a vehicle to import. As a vehicle to prepare, I'm going to use this pickup, generic pickup model by OK from TurboSquid. We'll go back to Blender, we'll go File, Open, don't need to save. And this is the file we've just downloaded. So I'm also going to hit this little cog here and hit Uncheck Load UI. This will ensure that the standard Blender interface is used. Press open. Now we can see that this vehicle has a lot of stuff already built into it. We don't need a lot of this. I'm going to quickly go through how to reset this, but this isn't a full Blender tutorial. This is more about the toolkit. So we'll just delete every object we don't need. We'll go over to the armature and the pose and come down to this pose tab. We want to go to the rest position, which resets those wheels. Then we want to find everything in the world, expand every tab out. Press A, which will select everything. Then we want to come up to object and go parent, clear and keep transformation. We want to go object, apply, all transforms, and now we also want to delete anything related to the armature. So we'll delete everything on the wheel rig system and that collection. And also under here, we'll delete car arm base. And then we've got a few more things to clean up. Just delete those. Delete the empty. There's nothing in static. And that looks about right. So now we can begin preparing this vehicle. So now the vehicle's good to go. We're going to be setting up this pickup as a 4x4, as it's the vehicle type that most closely matches. It only supports two axles, so we'll leave that alone as two and press Create Standard Collections. This will then give us this new scene collection, which has a lot of sub collections underneath it. And we're going to sort all our geometry into this. So that's easy enough. We're just going to sort through the wheels first. I'll quickly explain about the wheels. Each wheel has two sub-collections underneath it. It's important to put your geometry into the correct bits if you want to take advantage of things like wheel deformation in the future, or if you don't want your wheel calipers to rotate with the wheels. And the wheel naming convention is the axles are numbered from front to back. So the front axle is axle 0, and in this case, the rear axle is axle 1. And if you were to have 2, 3, 4 axles, they would then be numbered increasing backwards. So here we've got the front left wheel. We're going to select the front tire and also the rim. We're going to find them up here and we're going to click and drag those down into wheel 0L. And then we'll just get the rim, which is this one here, and we'll drag that into the rim. There doesn't appear to be any brake calipers here, so we can just leave the brake caliper collection empty. And we'll quickly do that for the rest of the vehicles too. So now the wheels are done. I'm just going to shrink those down and I'll just check both of the left ones are correct. If I press this little hide in viewport button here, I can see the front left wheel disappears, the rear left wheel, and if I go over the other side, nothing changes on this side. And if I change the right wheel visibility, we see that disappears correctly. And if we go over the left side, the right wheel doesn't affect the left side at all, which is exactly what we want. So now if we hide all the wheels, we can then see everything else left on the vehicle to sort out. Now on the body, there's Windows interior and Windows exterior. If you separate your windows to use Windows interior and Windows exterior correctly, that will avoid any sorting problems in Unreal where the interior window accidentally draws over the top of the outside window, which looks really strange. So I recommend splitting up your windows if you need to in this. However, this vehicle doesn't have an interior, so that's just opaque geometry. So we're going to leave the windows alone. For the headlights though, we can see that there's actually covers over these headlights. So we're going to sort the headlight covers into body transparent. If we go into viewport shading mode, we can just quickly see which ones are there. So it looks like it's these. So they're under, it's these ones. So we'll just drag those back down into body transparent. And I like to hide the collection that I'm working into so I can see any remaining geometry that might need to be sorted back into it. So now that that's complete, that looks fine. So the rest of this all looks like body. So we can pretty much just select the rest of the geometry and sort it into the body as appropriate. So now there's nothing left in the scene. So we'll delete the original remaining collections and we'll turn all the visibility back on this vehicle. And that's that. Now we'll just quickly save this as pickupexample.blend. So when we export the vehicle, it's going to read the Blender scene name. So it's important that you choose a nice scene name for your vehicle. So in this case, pickupexample is what we want. Now we're going to work through this menu on the right here. We'll start with setup scene scale. This will ensure that the Blender scene scale matches the Unreal scene scale, so there's no issues with the export and import process. If your scene is in the default scale, it will automatically resize all of your geometry. If not, you might need to rescale your geometry to match. But for now, we can just hit setup scale and we can see the vehicle become a lot larger, which is correct. And if we come down to this world tab here and expand units, we can see it's now metric and 0.01. This is exactly what we want. Now we just run through these next few buttons. So we're going to hit prepare vehicle for Unreal. So we can see here the vehicle sort of looks ghosted, looks duplicated. That's actually normal. During the prepare vehicle for Unreal stage, it recenters the geometry and makes sure it sits on the ground. So yeah, don't be afraid if that happens. What we will do though is we will now hide the original vehicle. And I encourage you to just look through this vehicle, make sure that there's no obvious defects that have come through. We want to ensure that all the normals are correct, no geometry is malformed, because what it's done is it's actually combined all the meshes as we need, and it's also taken measurements of the wheels for later in the process. So if we just look through, make sure it looks visually okay, and then it's fine. Now we need to set up the rig for Unreal. Down here, we just need to press rig vehicle for export. There's also this decimate mesh option. So this add-on will also create a proxy mesh for the physics asset in Unreal. Unreal needs a reasonably accurately sized skeletal mesh to create a physics asset off of. We don't need that to be the full detail of this model. If I show the statistics of this model, we can see that it's actually nearly a million triangles. So in this case, we probably want to decimate that down. If we just leave that to 10% decimation, we'll see what that looks like. And this can take a few seconds to process. So now that's processed, we can now see that we've got this armature set up and we've also once again got a couple of vehicles. So we're going to hide the prepped vehicle and we can see that the top vehicle still remains. That's normal. What's happened is we've now got this skeletal mesh, which is going to be used for the proxy mesh as described before. But then we've also got all these static meshes, which are now all centered around the origin. which means in Unreal, they are attached to those bones on the rig and they will be placed correctly within Unreal. But we don't want any additional offsets here. So this all looks fine. But once again, I recommend you have a quick look around, make sure there's no obvious defects. For this proxy mesh, we want to make sure that there's no triangles that are extending out very long. We want to make sure that the wheels haven't obviously deformed and changed shape too much. It doesn't matter if any of the normals look a little bit wonky or if the geometry goes a little bit strange. We just want to make sure that the shape and the bounding box of these vehicles all looks correct. So if we hit show bounds over here, we can see that this bounding box looks correct. It looks fairly tight to the geometry. So this looks pretty fine and the wheel looks good, looks like a good shape. So now we'll hit hide bounds and we'll show that static mesh again. If you had any problems with Blender at any of these stages, you can always just press prepare vehicle or rig vehicle again, and it will just delete that collection and recreate that step. This is a fairly non-destructive process, so that original vehicle collection remains untouched and all changes are made in those subsequent collections. So you can always move back to an earlier stage and progress forward again. So now we're ready to export. This once again will take a few seconds. So we just click that and it's going to output our model next to our blend file on disk. So now that's completed. This was our pickup example.blend file, and we can go to export pickup example, which is where it's exported all these files. So we've got all these FBX files now, and we've also got this very important .json file. If you open that with a text editor, you can actually see that it's got the name of the vehicle, it's got all the meshes specified within here, and it's also got important details like the wheel radius, the rim radius, and the body dimensions, which will be used to set up the physics in Unreal correctly. So now we can move on to the Unreal side. Open your Unreal project that has Rush Hour enabled, and we'll open up the Vehicle Importer menu. So to do that, we're going to come down to the content browser, go to the settings on the right, and make sure we have Show Engine Content and Show Plugin Content enabled. Then over on the left here, we want to expand out Engine, expand out Plugins, and scroll down until we find Rush Hour. So once you've found Rush Hour Vehicle Animator content, we want to open up the Blueprints folder. And then in here, scroll down, we'll expand that out, and we can see EUW Vehicle Importer. Right click that and go Run Editor Utility Widget. This gives us the menu for importing vehicles. If you already have your materials in Unreal, regardless of what options you have here, the original Unreal materials will be assigned first. Only if a material can't be found will it then import these materials. Importing the materials is a good way to have placeholder materials, but I do recommend creating materials in Unreal to begin with. So for now, we're going to choose Import Materials, Import Textures. Yes, we want to use Nanite. You can turn Nanite off if you don't want to use Nanite. In this case, assigning Rush Hour materials won't matter because the materials in Blender are not named the same as the Rush Hour materials. The way it finds existing materials is purely based on that name. For the vehicle type, the one that closest matches is the 4x4. We only have soft suspension at the moment, but more will be coming in the future. So let's select that and press import. Beside the original Blender file, there's this new export pickup example as we explored before. We want to choose that JSON file that we had a look at. Click that and press open, and this begins the import process. This can take a few minutes, so we'll come back when this is complete. So now the importer has completed. We can see that this message log has popped up and it's raised some warnings here. These warnings are typically related to UV mapping that isn't quite right. I don't so much mind for this example, but I do recommend that you have proper UV mapping on your vehicles. So close that and we'll close the importer. One good thing to do is to check out the output log. To open that, go to Window and enable output log. In the output log, just scroll up a little bit. Make sure that there's no red lines related to the new vehicle import. If there is, do your best to correct it. Feel free to ask in the Discord if you've got any questions about what went wrong. Go back to the content browser and scroll back up to our project. And we can see there's this new imported vehicles folder. And in this folder, we've got another folder named the same as our vehicle. Open that up and we can see there's all these new static meshes and all these other assets. If you open up one of the wheels, you can see that these settings are the same that were measured within Blender. But the one thing we need to do is a little bit of cleanup on this physics asset. So open up the physics asset. And we can see that these capsules don't quite line up with the geometry all that well. So if we just select body and then come down to the primitive type and change that to single convex hull, press regenerate bodies, we can see that that's a much better approximation. You can scale it and rotate it if you'd like, if it's still not quite lining up. But for now, this is good. You can also increase the max hull verts to get a more accurate shape as well. But this is good enough. So then we select all the wheels in one go, and we change that primitive type to sphere. Press regenerate bodies, and we can see that those are much closer also as well. So press save, and our vehicle should be drivable. So to test that out, we're going to scroll down once again to the rush hour folder, the blueprints folder, right click this training menu, run editor utility widget, and we're going to load training environment and choose that pickup example. I'm going to pop this out so we can see this a little bit better. So now if we hit begin training, we can see our lovely new pickup is driving. And that's all that's involved in importing the vehicle. Remember that this is an optional workflow. If you have an existing vehicle pipeline, or if you have vehicles with complex suspension setups or vehicles that don't line up with the existing templates, that's fine. You can import those as normal, but for very common use cases, this is a very, very quick way to get a working vehicle in Unreal. And because these vehicles are regular chaos vehicles, you can tweak the physics on these if you'd like as well. I hope that's provided a clear overview of this workflow. I can't wait to see what everyone creates with it.